Hi folks, welcome back. I hope you're all doing well. Now, as you get into prompt engineering and start to use prompting patterns like chain of thought or the React pattern that calls external tools, you quickly run into the need for templating your prompts, performing logic on your prompts, performing logic on the replies to your prompts, and so on. And by now, there's a bunch of libraries. The most notable one is LangChain, which try to perform that function. And this paper takes that a few steps further. It's from the recent PLDI conference, Programming Languages Design and Implementation. And it kind of takes a programming language designer's point of view on how to query large language models. The basic idea in the paper is to say that what you really need is more of a full-blown programming language that lets you express all the logic and the constraints and the variables that are needed for prompting LLMs, rather than the kind of string interpolation, string substitution that current libraries like LangChain are based on. And the authors propose a new language called LMQL, Language Model Query Language, to do that. Let's look at a couple of examples of writing queries in this language to get a sense for what it tries to do. So here are a couple of examples, and it shows that using this language, you can do scripted prompting, you can perform logic on top of your prompts, you can constrain the output that the LLM returns, and you can have some sort of control flow. You'll notice that the overall structure of the prompt is similar to that of an SQL query. The first argument up here, beam or argmax, specifies the kinds of completion you're asking the LLM to do. And then you have a string prompt, but notice that within the prompt, you have placeholders for variables. So things like this in square brackets are variables. The from clause specifies which model you're querying. And then you have a where clause, which specifies constraints on the completions or on the variables. For example, this is a prompt for generating jokes, and you have constraints on the joke variable and the punchline variable for when you want to stop generation. For example, you're saying that you want to stop when the joke ends in a question mark, and you want to stop when the punchline ends in the word end. You can specify other constraints like the length of the completion or the number of characters in a completion. And you can even have logic like for loops within your prompt. You can think of this almost as a prompt compiler because this is working at a level of abstraction above the specific language model. It's almost like a front-end and back-end separation between the logic in your prompt and the model itself. And this facilitates your prompts being independent of the underlying language model. That very first argument we saw, argmax or beam, specifies the kind of decoding you're asking your language model to do. So argmax is greedy decoding, which means it picks the token with the highest probability and then feeds it back into the model, and that's how it generates completions for your prompt. It's greedy because it's only looking at the probability of the very next token rather than looking at the probability of a longer completion. Beam search is somewhere in the middle and tries to predict several sequences of completions and then picks the top sequences. One of the things this kind of prompting with a programming language style really enables is meta prompts, where you use things that a previous prompt returned in the next prompt. So it's kind of like you assigned a variable in one prompt and you used the value of that variable in another subsequent prompt. Another very common thing to do in prompt engineering is to have constraints on the returned answers. You often want the things that the LLM returns to be in some kind of a format or have some kind of a length constraint. And that's what this language is trying to encode with the kind of length and stop word constraint that we see in the where section. At runtime, it essentially interprets the logic in the prompt. It's a subset of Python. It does the kinds of things you would expect it to do. So each string in the prompt is directly given to the language model, but then you have these variables within the prompt. If it's within square brackets, it means that is a variable hole, which means when the language model returns something to fill that hole or fill that blank, it's assigned to that variable. If it's within curly brackets, that looks up the value of a variable and substitutes that value at the given place in the prompt. When you use things like beam decoding, that is essentially doing a parallel search with all the initial completions and the number of beams that you want to search over. At the end of running the prompt, the system gives you back an interaction trace, which is a raw transcript of all the queries and the back and forth with the language model. So how do we evaluate this? We're looking for a couple of main things. One is expressiveness. We want to see if this language is able to succinctly express the common prompting techniques that we know about, things like chain of thought or the React pattern, and do so in a readable way. And the other thing we want to see is what kind of performance or cost this incurs. Does it save us the number of tokens generated? Does it save us some calls to the LLM? So let's look at a couple of concrete examples with some well-known prompting patterns. This example is encoding a chain of thought prompting pattern to pick the odd element out of a set. It consists of a few short prompt, which provides a few examples, and it contains a few variables where you will provide reasonings and the result. You also have a where clause that puts some constraints on those variables. For example, you want the reasoning variable to not get too long. Again, note how if you were doing this raw without a language like this, you would be writing code or logic to encode all these constraints in your prompt engineering stack somewhere. And you see some fairly sizable gains. The accuracy on the task itself is pretty much the same, which is expected because you're not changing the model or the logic of the prompt itself. What you do see is that the model queries, the number of times you call out to the model, and the number of billable tokens reduces drastically. You can see drops of 40%, 26%, 30% in these parameters, and that directly translates to real cost reductions. Here's another example of the React prompting pattern. This is the prompting pattern where you ask the LLM a question and tell it to reply in a pattern of alternating thoughts and actions, where some of the actions could be that you need to look up something, maybe do a web search or look up Wikipedia for some fact. And you can see how you're able to set up this entire React prompt fairly succinctly and in a very readable way. You have a basic few shot example here, and then you have some logic which looks at whether the LLM is coming back with a thought or an action. And if the action is search, you can call out to your Wikipedia or web search. You can also very succinctly embed constraints on how long the thought should be, when you want to stop generating, and all that goes in the where clause over here. And with this example, you see even larger savings, up to 85% in the number of billable tokens. So that was a quick look at a paper that proposes that the way to do prompt engineering is to really design a proper language to do that, one that can perform logic on the prompts itself, on the replies from the LLM, that can encode constraints on the replies of the LLM. And doing this not only makes your entire prompt and the logic surrounding it a lot more readable, a lot more succinct, but it has the very practical advantage of reducing your overall cost in terms of the number of calls or the number of billable tokens that you use with the LLM. I hope you enjoyed that. If you like content like this, please consider subscribing, like the video, and I will see you next time. Thank you very much.